the board in closed session. Hello?
All right.
The board in closed session considered and voted to approve the settlement with RSNM and Ronald S. McCarthy in the case of RSM versus Alamance County, and the county attorney will now report the terms of that settlement and enter the settlement document into the minutes of this meeting.
The settlement agreement has been reached with RSNM, and the action they brought against Alamance County for fees claimed due under the contract for reevaluation. RSNM appraisal has denied any liability to the county and resolved to compromise and settle their differences with the county, and in doing so, they've agreed to pay the county $155,000 by wire transfer or certified check within 30 days of today. And in consideration of this, Alamance County is going to release Ron McCarthy and RSNM Appraisal Services Company in this matter, and RS McCarthy will release Alamance County. It'll be a mutual release. Now, this is independent of a settlement with Kimberly D. Horton. That case will continue against Ms. Horton, and our counterclaims against her are going to continue. And I will hand this into the clerk to be sealed and entered into the record.
Thank you.
Any commissioners' comments at this time?
Yeah, I'm going to say what I got on my mind.
Okay.
I felt like I was in the lion's den tonight, and maybe not as many lions are in here as there were. I don't think the American people, especially those who work in government, have their handle on what is ahead for this nation. I don't know how much more they've got to see. Nationwide, worldwide. Cost of government just keeps getting higher and higher and higher. You could say that the people are demanding more and more and more as a result. That's the cause of that. Larger government, more government. But I can tell you now that if we bankrupt it any further, and we're there, folks. If you don't believe it, turn on the television and look at what's going on around the world. The capital of Pennsylvania, if I'm not mistaken, it was just reported the other day, had to file for bankruptcy. The whole state of California is probably there now. And you hear from people raise taxes. You know, I've only had two situations where somebody says raise taxes. Either the liberal tax and spenders, they say it, and then people who are paid by taxes, they say it. And I've never really quite understood that to a degree. It's hard for me to say this because I know people hate me for my position, especially people who want more salary, more benefits, more of what government can give them. But what we see is a difference between private business and public. In private business, employees wouldn't have the audacity to do what we see done, not only here, but elsewhere. But in a public arena, it just seems like it's okay. And I'm telling you, until that mindset changes and there comes a meeting of the minds as to the bottom line, P&Ls, and it's just going to get worse. This government is spending almost 40 cents of every dollar to run this nation. And we're part of the puzzle,
You mean we're borrowing 40,
yeah,
40 cents?
I don't want to say it, but yeah, the government's spending 40 cents of every dollar the government spends at federal level supposedly is borrowed money. Okay. And it's just a mindset of we can't do it any better. We can't do it any cheaper. We can't be more efficient. It's almost like it's a popularity contest. Private business doesn't operate that way. Private business sees they got a problem, they take care of it if you're a good business. Public business doesn't seem to have that mindset. And that's why I think public business is having such a problem. No, I'm not going to vote for a tax increase unless somebody tells us that something we need to do is going to cost, raise taxes. I possibly made a mistake when I didn't push for looking further at the financing of the repairs that we had to do. I told Craig the other day, if it had been hammered home, the only way we can do this is to raise taxes this amount of money, take it or leave it. I would have liked to have had that to analyze. But the door was open, the windows were open, so I thought, well, yeah, we'll do it, and we'll try to do it with savings or growth in our economy. Look what happened. But I've never seen such a mindset worldwide. Well, we can't do it any better. Look at Greece. Look at what's going on in Greece. 50-some percent of the people in Greece work for the government, if I'm not mistaken. And they're rioting in the streets. And we just think it ain't going to happen here, that it can't happen here. Well, I got news for you, folks. It can happen here, and it will happen here if we don't get our fiscal house in order. And our county is part of that puzzle. Now, you can look at some counties our size. Their general funds, I'm not going to mention the counties because somebody's going to holler, well, I don't live there. Well, one county, $17 million less than ours. General fund, $17 million less than ours. Another county's $9 million less than ours. Both those counties have the same population. One has double square miles. Sure, it's not apples to apples. One's got 200 and some less employees. The county that's got $9 million less than us in the general fund each year's got the same number of employees than us. We might get through this situation for this year with what we're getting ready to do, but long term, I've said it before, we've got to meet with everybody, make sure it can't be done cheaper, or if it can be done cheaper, do it. Run it like a business and quit running it like a government. And that's exactly what we're doing. We're running it like a government. We're letting the employees tell us what to do. Now, I don't mean employees per se in this county, but we're letting the people out there tell us what to do. And we're supposed to be managing this. You're supposed to be managing this. Tim's supposed to be managing this. The inmates don't run the asylum. And I mean that with respect. The nation's about to come to its knees. And when it comes to its knees, you ain't going to have nothing. I told the school system one time, if you bankrupt the system, what do you think you're going to have then? What do you think you're going to have? You'll work for a lot less, and you'll be thankful that you got that. It staggers my mind that people don't see what's happening. Nobody thinks they're overworked. I mean, excuse me, underworked. Nobody thinks they're overpaid. Nobody. Just take care of me for now. I understand that. But I think we've lost our way. I know we've lost our way in this world. We've lost our way in this nation. We've lost our way locally. And I've got to speak out. There's a better way to do it. There's a cheaper way to do it. There's a more efficient way to do it. And I challenge everybody that's got a way to do it to do it. That's why I push for performance-based budgeting. But it took so long to get it even partly initiated that we can't reap any benefits from it now. It doesn't appear. But I hope we can still push for it. But I'm saddened that the state of affairs has gotten to be the way it is in our country, and I think all the way down here to the local level. Just raise taxes. That's a heck of a solution.
Are you through?
I'm through.
Any more commissioners' comments? Any announcements?
Just want to remind everybody, Friday is the Piedmont Food Agricultural Grand Opening. It's at 2 o'clock.
In Hillsboro?
In Hillsboro, on Valley Forge Road.
That's Friday.
This Friday.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Any other announcements? We are adjourned.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the commissioners' website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.